Robert, prepare yourself for a shock. Julia is going to divorce me.
I'll be the first to congratulate her.
How can you say that? You know I don't want a divorce. I'm a happily married man. I love my wife.
And besides, all this property's in her name.
She's going to strip me right down to my underwear, too.
You ought to think of that before you go galloping after something you shouldn't have and can't catch. Who is it this time?
Sheila Winthrop. I bought her this. My wife found it in my pocket.
I imagine you had a good reason for buying that for Miss Winthrop.
I certainly did. We're good friends.
Oh, I see.
And besides, it's none of your business.
I agree with you.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. You're in this too, you know.
Me? What have I got to do with it?
Well, I told Julia that you bought this for Sheila. I told her you were in love with her.
Oh, you did you? Well, I'm going to tell her differently.
You don't have to. She doesn't believe it anyway. Please, Robert, you've got to help me. If you get me out of this jam, it'll never happen again. No more galloping. I swear it. Please, Robert.
All right, all right. What do you want me to do?
Well, it's very simple. Tonight, I'll take Julia to the Crystal Roof for our anniversary dinner. You bring Sheila there and prove to my wife that you are in love with Sheila.
What? Well, what would Sheila think?
Make her believe it, too. Because if she doesn't, Julia won't. That won't be difficult. She has a very friendly disposition. Turn on the old charm, you know. Fascinate her. Throw stardust in her eyes. Do anything so long as you make my wife believe I was telling the truth when I was lying to her.